Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I wanted to do a video today where I react to a reaction, or where I react to your comments to one of my reactions. I recently did a video, Borbo the 200-pound monsters. And for some reason, some of you guys are really invested in the notion of a 200-pound working Borbo. Like I said, it's not my thing. I prefer function over form, workability over size. So that was my thing. But I got a lot of, kickback in the comment section. One of the things was about me comparing, one of the critiques was me comparing the Borbo to the Rottweiler, Cane Corso, and these other breeds. Now, honestly, that was a little inartful on my part. I wasn't trying to say that a Borbo should weigh the exact same as a Rottweiler, Cane Corso, or Dogo. I think those are the three breeds I mentioned. I was more so saying that at 125 pounds, a master breed, becomes big enough, heavy enough to do the work. For the record, to me, an ideal working weight for a Borbo would be somewhere between 135 and 150 pounds. That would be to do the work that the breed was intended to do in South Africa. I don't have any experience, never been to South Africa, but just looking at the work that it's doing, the expectations that I've the expectations that I think the breed has in terms of the work that it has to do, I think that would be optimum weight. I think 200 pounds, again, is just way too much. But I wanted to share a couple of comments with you guys because I think that, you know, like I said, people are really invested in the notion of these bigger dogs. And so let's get into the comments. Let's first check this one out. Excuse me. All right, so this comes from a guy named Sestum. This is a long comment. He had a lot to say. You know, he told me to stop comparing the dogs, to stop comparing the Borbo to Rottweilers, which was not my intention. I was just kind of trying to talk about a group of different breeds that kind of do the same thing and what would be a general weight that the breeds could start at and be functional at that weight. But anyway, he says, this is Sesta. What's up, Sesta? Thanks for watching the channel. Hope you subscribe. He says, this is South Africa. This is his comment. This is South Africa, where for the homestead, you're dealing with 6 to 12 intruders at a time, and your boy needs a size to intimidate them. All right, I'm going to take these points one at a time or just break them off. First and foremost, I don't think a person would be more fearful of a 200-pound dog as opposed to a 150-pound dog. Most times when dogs get above 110 pounds, 120 pounds, they just become huge dogs to people, and people aren't really trying to engage dogs that big, plain and simple. But I would suggest that at 200 pounds, if I was breaking into your house, I would prefer to see a 200-pound dog because when I was younger and I was more athletic and I was in great shape, I would feel comfortable thinking that I could, like in a sprint, a 25-yard sprint, you know, over a fence, up on top of something, I could probably beat a 200-pound dog in that foot race. And I know you guys, some other comments were about, you know, these dogs are super fast. They're super agile. That just kind of goes against what I've seen, what I know about dogs and looking at the dogs. I mean, first of all, let me just say this. I don't like to talk about myself being an expert or me have any special insights, anything, because I'm really not. I'm just a guy that makes, you know, I'm a filmmaker who loves dogs, and I talk to a lot of people, and I've been a lot of places. I've seen a lot of dogs. And some of you guys just watch stuff on the internet and you read things, you read fantastic stories, and you think because you read a fantastic story, that makes you an expert on that thing. you guys got to realize, just because you read it on the internet doesn't necessarily make it true. And, you know, some things are for entertainment, you know, or some stories are sensationalized because the person who's telling the story has a love and passion for the story they're telling. So I say all that to say that a 200-pound dog is very unlikely. It is very unlikely that a 200-pound dog is as agile or as fast as a 150-pound dog. And it's even less likely that it's faster than or as agile as a 100-pound dog. That's just physics. And if you look at the dogs that were in the Beastly video, those dogs were very stocky, very bulky. They didn't even have the conformation for if you understand dog conformation, they didn't have the optimum conformation for running and jumping. And I'm just going to leave it at that because I want to get into some things in this video. I want to get some more things in this video. So he goes on to say, in the bush, the dog must defend against hyena, leopard, cheetah, caracal, lion, and big male baboons to protect the livestock, and they need to be around 160 to 180 pounds. All right, cool. 160 to 180 pounds, it's not 200 pounds, so that's getting closer to, okay, I'm starting to understand what you're saying. But what kills me is like, yo, dude, a boar bull is not going to fight off hyenas. Now, what happens, you have to understand, first and foremost, wild animals aren't really looking for fights. And that's the beauty of livestock guardian breeds, is that if they present an aggressive front, most predators they're looking for an easy meal. They're not looking for a fight. So they're going to just go somewhere else. If you're saying that a huge dog, again, intimidates a hyena, a leopard, or a cheetah, you know, yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think a 150-pound dog would do just as well as a 200-pound dog in terms of presenting a offensively defensive front to a predator. I don't think I don't know how many boar bulls it would take to kill a lion. I don't know that there's any boar bulls that's going to catch a cheetah. Leopards, the caracal is a small cat. It's a 45-pound cat, I believe. A 100-pound dog could take care of a caracal. At least we'll have a decent fight against it. Obviously, the baboon, I think baboons weigh about 88 pounds. 150-pound dog should be able to deal with a baboon, or even a 125-pound dog. I've never really seen baboons fight. I know they have those huge fangs in their... they're part of the monkey family, so they're very agile and all that stuff. I have seen video, though, of baboons taking out... of warblers taking out a baboon, so I know that's possible. I know that they were used to hunt leopards, but I don't think they stand much of a chance against lions and hyenas. So, you know, supersizing a dog doesn't give him a better opportunity or give him a better chance at killing a lion or dealing with a lion in a fight. So, I don't understand the fascination with these having these dogs be supersized. It doesn't really jive with my understanding of how canines work. But then again, oh, I'm sorry, not then again, but furthermore, let's talk about the fact that there were some other people who seemed to think that I wasn't familiar with the breed standard. And I'll be honest with you, I didn't necessarily read the breed standard before I made that video because I had, 5-6 years ago, I was considering buying a Borable. So I had pretty much familiarized myself with the breed standard. And I knew that in most of the breed standards, there was really not a definitive weight listed for the breeds. It's always about, they give you the height and they say the dog should be, you know, he should be thick bone, massive, heavy, dense muscle, all this stuff. It should be proportionate. Height and weight should be proportionate. Whatever that means. Obviously, that's something that judges know. Excuse me. Now, on the AKC website, it does say, not in the breed standard, but it does say the breed gets up to 200 pounds. Now, the AKC is a show registry. And I'm not saying that a Borable can't get up to 200 pounds, 200 plus pounds even. I'm just saying that's not a working Borable. And we know that the AKC is notorious for disregarding working standards when it comes to confirmation and showing dogs. So, you know, for you guys that are, you know, that hit me over the head with, oh, you should read the breed standard. I read the breed standard and I have it here. This is a South African Borable Breeder Society. And their standard says, height must always be in relation to mass. Ideal ratio is, for a full-grown dog, is approximately 1 to 1 or 1.2 centimeters per kilogram. Overall balance and conformation of major body components. Okay. So then it says the ideal height of a male is 66 centimeters. So 1 to 1, that would be 66 kilograms. And then 1 to 1.2, that would be roughly 79 kilograms. I did the math earlier, and 79 kilograms is roughly 175 pounds. So it's a big dog, and I think it's above a working weight that I would feel comfortable with, but it's still not 200 pounds. And on a canine, 25 pounds is a lot of weight. When you go from a 50-pound dog to a 75-pound dog, those are two different sized dogs. So yeah, 25 pounds is a lot for a canine. So even in the, like I said, the South African Breeders, Borable Breeder Society, they say that the max weight of a Borable is 175 pounds. So that's that. But then I wanted to do one more thing before I go. I wanted to share with you guys a video of what I feel like is the exemplification. Let me get this thing straight before you guys. Hold on. Let me do this. Let's see. This is a video on YouTube. It's called Borables Are Chasing Baboons. And I just feel like this is what you get when you get a 200-pound dog working on a farm. And like I said, I'm not from South Africa. I've never been to South Africa. I would love to go. But I haven't been. But I feel like this is what you get with a 200-pound dog on a farm. As you can see, there's some Borables out there. And there's a relatively large Borable loping after the baboons. Now, I believe Borables move at a top speed of around 20 miles per hour. Baboons at a top speed of around 30 miles an hour. You see that little terrier, though? That terrier is serious business. That's what you need. Oh, the terrier's about to get eaten, but... Yeah, that, I mean, in terms of, like, you know, actually, if you're talking about actually engaging in a baboon, that's what you need. You need a dog with that kind of speed. But you have these huge Borables just pretty much loping around. These guys are going to be here all day. The baboon is literally running in circles. Now, obviously, the dog is, okay, let me stop it there. Obviously, the dog is very effective in defending and scaring off the baboon. He's a big dog, and really, that's all you need the dog to do. But, you know, again, at 150 pounds, he might actually catch the baboon, engage it, and keep it away. Right now, the baboon is, you know, he's just toying with the dog. He'll come and go as he pleases. He knows the dog can't run him down. So he'll come and go as he pleases. And that's kind of my thing is that, you know, like, yes, the dogs are big. They're impressive. They look good. And at 200 pounds, they probably make for great companions. But if you're looking at a dog, first of all, if I'm feeding a dog, you know, feeding a 200-pound dog is like 7-8 pounds of meat a day. I feed raw. You know, that's, you know, 3-4 pounds of, 3 or 4 pounds on a cheap end to get meat. You know, you're looking at, you know, $21-$28 a day just to feed that dog. So that's a lot for me, and that's a part of the equation and why I just want my dogs to fit in a working weight, because I feel like, you know, they're healthier, they'll live longer, and they're less expensive to feed premium food. And I hope this kind of addresses some of your issues that you guys have, some of the folks who advocate for the 200-pound Borbu. Again, I understand, like, we love big things. Big things are great. Bigger the better, I guess, is something that we come to learn and love here in the United States. But it's just not, to me, it's not ideal. It's not optimum. So I'm pushing for working weights. You know, I just feel like it's, you know, I think your dog would definitely be happier. One of the comments that someone left in the comment section was talked about on those 200-pound dogs, what about the joints? And especially like on a farm like that, see, that dog is running uneven ground. He's running. Those joints are being, you know, that's a lot of pressure. But anyway, guys, that's my rebuttal. If you still got problems, you still want to advocate for the 200-pound Borbu, leave it in the comments section. I might have to make another video and just keep this thing going, because I do feel like, you know, in this situation, I feel like I'm right. We need to have working dogs at working weights, you know? That's just how I feel about it. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.